I have been studying Australian plants for about 40 years. I've never seen a disease move as fast as myrtle rust in the plant world. What we're looking at here is an old dead adult Rhodomyrtus, psidioides, native guava. And from being a common tree of coastal rainforest, this species is now critically endangered just as a result of that one disease in 12 years. And nowadays, most of these populations survive just as suckers, which are still coming up from the old root system before myrtle rust knocks them down again. So a species can't survive like this. One of the things that is happening is we're urgently collecting live sample material from the populations that remain in the wild because they're going to be gone before long. And we also score the health of the plant that we're taking it from. That's because we're still trying to build up a picture of how the disease acts in the environment, and we're also trying to detect any plants which might be unusually resistant to the disease. And what we're doing then is taking them into protected growing conditions where we can study the disease, study how the plant reacts to the disease.
The ex situ collection provides the material for the scientists to trial different methods to see if there's any innate resistance within the species. That's important because then we can use those resistant genotypes to reinforce the natural populations and hopefully be able to come up with something that will survive in the wild.
A national myrtle rust response really requires an effort from a whole bunch of different science and horticulture levels of expertise. Botanic gardens, both metropolitan and regional ones, are proving to be a really important part of a network of institutions that can hold parts of that collection. Should myrtle rust break out at any one institution, it can be controlled with fungicide, but we don't want to risk everything in one place. One of the biggest contributions that community groups and land care groups can make is keeping track of which species that are most severely affected by myrtle rust still survive in their areas and where they are, and also perhaps in identifying individual plants or populations that may be more resistant to the rust. We're very much hoping that this native guava project will be a model for how we might deal with some of the other myrtle rust affected species, but also how we might be more prepared for other incoming environmental pests and diseases in the future.